The largest fire burning, again, is the High Park Fire. It's burning across 75,537 acres. It is still just 45% contained. Again, that's down from yesterday. 7 News reporter Amanda Kost live in Larimer County. And Amanda, you've been talking with the firefighters who are out there working in this heat today.
And Teresa, some of them fighting the fire you see behind me since day one. Others fresh off the truck from fighting another wildfire. Either way, they say they can use all the help that they can get if they're going to tame this beast of a wildfire. It's 1900 versus one. One relentless wildfire.
The marching orders is that they know exactly what they have faced in front of them.
A battle of David and Goliath proportions.
Hopefully, we David can pull out the magic bullet here.
We're throwing a lot of rocks at it.
Fire the right stone.
You know, in different forms.
These big fires, you're just at the whim of Mother Nature.
You just have to compete with what Mother Nature throws at us.
She's throwing a heck of a lot.
Yeah, you know, we this thing put us on one knee, but we got out pretty quick.
The driving force of the High Park Fire continues to knock progress.
And just when you think you're in the clear, it blows up again.
In numbers, crews armed with a strategy.
We have tricks that we can do, and that's taking advantage of every opportunity that we can get.
And an ally, relief coming from another fire. The Hewlett Burn area, anchoring the east side of this firefight.
The box is not quite sealed. But that's our goal, is to eventually close every flap of the box and put it to bed.
Until then, they fight.
We'll get it done. We're going to get it done.
And we asked the incident commanders of this fire what that stone is, what that one thing is that's going to take down this High Park wildfire. They say they need a massive water balloon. Teresa, rain is desperately needed in this area and areas all across the state to get a handle on these wildfires. Reporting live from Larimer County, Amanda Kost, 7 News.
Thank you, Amanda. And with all the new acreage, the High Park Fire, again, the second largest in state history, more than 75,000 acres. The only other bigger, the Hayman Fire that burned 137,760 acres 10 years ago across 4 different counties. A meeting right now for the residents evacuated from the High Park Fire. Today, firefighters say no more homes were lost. 7 News reporter Marc Stewart outside that meeting. And Marc, you're talking with residents who fear their homes were among those lost yesterday.
And Teresa, sadly, many of the people going through these gates realize they may be the ones getting the bad news that their homes were indeed destroyed. You may remember that chilling video yesterday of a home being destroyed near the Glacier View area. A short time ago, I talked to a couple. They have property almost adjacent to that home off of gate number 12. They just want to know one way or another if their property made it so they can move forward. They're just not convinced they will get the answer at this meeting tonight. We are also hoping to hear from the American Red Cross. The number of evacuees have been fluctuating, a very large number now out of their homes. The American Red Cross hopefully providing updates about accommodations, also about the distribution of supplies and other assistance. In addition, the Sheriff's Office expected to give a briefing as well to residents, many of them yearning for a timetable as to when they can return or perhaps go in and just see their property for a short bit of time. But they're very hesitant to set a timetable because, as we have seen, this fire from the start has been very unpredictable. Again, this meeting just getting underway. Hopefully, when we talk to you next, Teresa, we'll get a better idea about some answers to those many questions. For now, we are live in Loveland. Marc Stewart, 7 News.